Nat's a 34-year-old male with cerebral palsy, my son. He lives for sports. So Nat has his dream job, he works for the Phillies.
I walk him in a minute, I do the road, and the dance.
He has the same hopes and aspirations that most people do. Cerebral palsy is an aspect of his life, but it's certainly not his life.
I got the egos.
When we lived in the last house, any little mechanical need that he needed to adjust, you know, whether it was the TV getting louder, turning a light on because it was dark, any of these things, that fell to us. He had to call to us to take care of it. We were in and out of that room constantly to adjust things like the volume of the TV or the channel would change, or the room got dark and we needed to turn lights on, or we needed to adjust the shades on the windows. I think one of the important things that Voiceitt has brought to us is a little bit of liberation, not only in the day-to-day, but in terms of adopting things as they come forward.
WIP. I don't have to call my mom and dad in, or my assistant, and tell them, hey, I need this, I need that. I can do it independently. I got right on.
So Voiceitt has actually given Nat an opportunity to touch so many more things that are now in the mainstream. This allows him to do the same things other people do and more with his house. And that's what Voiceitt has opened for us.
I did it all the time. I did it to dinner, on the TV. I did Voiceitt, do everything.